Welcome back, runners. This is Koryamune, and this is the review of the new Adidas Adizero Adios 6. This is a pair of shoes that I bought with my money, and no one is paying me for this review. If you liked the video, please don't forget to leave a thumbs up so that I understand which kind of video you prefer, to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you won't miss any video and you will support the channel. Say that the Adios 6 is a road neutral shoe of 8mm drop, like the Brooks Hyperion Tempo, and with a weight of 9 ounces, 256 grams in the US 10 sides for the male version, and 7.8 ounces, 221 grams in the female version. It has a stack height of 27mm in the heel and 19mm in the forefoot. Previous model was 23mm in the heel, 13mm in the forefoot, so we lost 2mm drop, and overall the shoe has a higher profile than the Adios 5. In comparison with the Boston 9, with a stack height of 26mm, 16mm, it has 2mm of drop less, and it is few millimeter higher. So I thought it could be a similar shoe as the Boston 9, and actually after different trainings, slow runs, faster strides and tempo run, I have mixed impressions. So let's go through it. It is unfortunately a bit heavier than the previous version and also than the Boston 9, something I don't like, and it is different in the house sole, midsole and upper. So basically they did lots of changes as usual now, so if you have your favorite model, forget it. Before to jump to talk about the hot sole, let's introduce in the review video two different measurements. The harshness of the midsole material used, measured using a durometer, so-called Eurotest, and here you can see how stiff is the Lightstrike and how soft is the Lightstrike Pro. The measurement is a three-point estimation, which means three measurements and averaging them out. Moreover, the two running dynamic metrics, the average ground contact time, which is the time between the first part of the foot touch the ground and the last part of the foot leaves the ground. Lower ground contact times indicates a better efficiency. And the other metric is the vertical oscillation ratio, which is the ratio between the vertical oscillation and the stride length, which should be less than 10% in order to be more efficient. And here you can see the different values collected and the comparison with other shoes, and you can notice for which pace the shoe is better in the 5 tests executed at different paces. Overall, from these two measurements, we have observed that the Lightstrike Pro is softer than all the other foams I'm currently using. The Lightstrike is stiffer than all of them. The Adios 6 has a similar contact time like the Boston 9, but higher than the other shoes I'm currently using, and it is not efficient at the pace of 4 minutes 15 seconds per kilometer, 6 minutes 50 seconds per mile, or for slower paces, but rather for faster run. Let's start now talking about the house sole. We have plenty of rubber, much more thicker than in the previous Adios 5 and the Boston 9. Maybe for the durability, but considering the durability of the Boston 9 house sole, I don't understand why. It adds weight and also rigidity to the shoe because it's really thick and rigid. You can even hear it from the sound. The grip, as usual, is great, not only for the continental rubber, but even because the different patterns used, which unfortunately collects lots of small stones. The exposite foam is not that much, but in the forefoot, I believe, is the Lightstrike Pro, which is pretty soft, so I don't know how long it will last. Finally, there is an extended torsion system, as I hoped, because not only give stability, but it makes the shoe snappier. I must say, overall, I like this outsole, but pity that they used so thick rubber in the forefoot, which make it stiffer. So even if they use the Lightstrike Pro in the forefoot, which is soft thanks to the rubber rigidity, the benefit of the softer form is punished because the feeling is stiffer than in the Boston 9, for instance. The Lightstrike Pro is extended till the forefoot, but it starts from the mid of the foot, so when you land on the heel, you immediately feel the harshness of the Lightstrike foam, something not that comfortable, especially if you are using the Boston 9 with the Boost foam in the heel. But this is it, guys, and the Lightstrike is stiffer but lighter than the Boost foam. So we basically already talked about the material used in the midsole, which has a quite flat profile, which unfortunately it doesn't guide and support the heel to toe transition as I would, and as I noticed in other shoes with a rocker in the forefoot. But at least the torsion system is more extended throughout the shoe, so at a faster pace you can feel it, it makes the shoe really snappy. A little bit of carbon profile would be helpful in this case to guide and push forward the stride. The heel area is more narrow than in the Boston 9 and Adios 5, so it is not made for wool lengths on the heel because it is less stable. Jumping to talk about the upper, it doesn't look a new upper, rather an upper of an 80-90 shoe. With all this overlaid material and support in the forefoot, in the heel and in the lockdown system. I have to say that I'm not really a fan of them because I like more minimal shoes, but they give a little bit of structure and support, especially in the forefoot, where the mesh seems to be really thin, so I don't know how long it will last. But on the other hand, I tried the shoe during a really warm day and it was super breathable, so perfect for the summer season. The shoe fits through two sides, but in the forefoot it leaves that room which makes the shoe less stable in the change of direction and more weighted down than the previous version or even than the Boston 9, which upper wraps the foot well without leaving any room as I like it. The laces are traditional and the lockdown system is working well, thanks also to the great tank I would like to have in all my shoes. It is anchored well using a breathable elastic material and it has a nice padding on both sides of the lockdown system. The heel counter is rigid enough with the right padding so that I didn't have any issue with it. So in general, guys, considering the running dynamic metrics collected and my first impressions, I believe that the Adios 6 can be used as a daily trainer, even if I'm not sure how long it will last, especially in the upper. But due to the foam used, it's better at faster pace, starting, for instance, from 4 minutes per kilometer, 6 minutes 26 seconds per mile. The feeling with the Boston 9 and with the Adios 5 was better, I believe, especially due to the upper, which doesn't wrap well the foot, and the thick rubber in the forefoot, which they probably have used to block the torsion system. In conclusion, it's a good shoe for our rotation, but nothing exciting. At least the price is not that high as for other shoes. So guys, this is it for today. If you like the video, please don't forget to leave a thumbs up so I know what kind of video you prefer. Hit the subscribe button here below to support the channel and don't miss any new video. As usual, thanks for watching and see you soon in the next one.